In this video, I'm not gonna show you what a boring repetitive shader setup looks like. If you are looking to discover how to turn this mess into a one-click action, you definitely want to stick around for this one. Welcome back to Primal VFX. I'm your host, Scott, and if you want to see more cool shit like that, smash that like button, subscribe for more awesomeness, and let's dive in right now. If you are looking to streamline your shader workflows in Maya, then Substance to Maya is a total game changer. Whether you are a seasoned professional or just starting out, this plugin will save you hours on every project by eliminating the tedious work of manual PBR materials setups. And today I'm super excited to announce the release of Substance to Maya version 2.0. If you use S2M before, you know it's been your go-to tool for creating fully configured PBR shaders in just one click. No more manual work, just import your textures, and the plugin automatically setups all the connections you need. It's a major time saver. When you're dealing with albedo, roughness, metalness, normal, and even emissive, opacity, and displacement channels. Plus, it supports the industry standard ASIS-OCO workflow, so you can be sure your renders will look top-notch from the start. Missed the full V1 breakdown? No worries. I've linked the tutorial from version 1.0 up in the top right corner, so you can check that out whenever you want. But now, let's dive into what's new and improved in version 2.0. First up, expanded compatibility. Substance to Maya now supports Maya 2022 up to Maya 2024. So whether you're running the latest version or using a slightly older setup, I've got you covered. This ensures that no matter where you are in your pipeline, S2M will work seamlessly with your current version of Maya. Next, I've got a brand new interface that I'm really excited about. The layout has been totally redesigned with collapsible tabs. This means you can organize your workspace exactly how you want it, hiding the settings you don't need, so your workflow is much more streamlined and clutter-free. No more jumping between endless options. It's all right there when you need it. Another huge upgrade is the ability to customize your texture paths. You now have complete control over where your textures are stored and sourced. This is perfect if you're working on a project across multiple drives or using a specific folder structure. Just set the path once, and the plugin will handle the rest, keeping everything organized and easy to find. And here's a big time saver. You can now add custom suffixes to all your texture channels, giving you more flexibility when dealing with complex texture sets. This is especially helpful when you are working with large projects that have dozens of maps. It will help you keep everything organized. But that's not all. Even better, Substance to Maya now saves your preferences for these custom suffixes, so the next time you launch Maya, your settings are already there, ready to go. If you ever want to reset the original settings, you can revert everything back to default with just one click. This addition is going to save you tons of time, especially when you are bouncing between different projects or collaborating with a team. And finally, I've tackled some bug fixes to ensure an even smoother and more reliable experience. I know a lot of you have reached out with feedback, and I'm happy to say those issues have been resolved to make sure the plugin works without a hitch. So that's it for the new features in Substance to Maya 2.0. This update brings more compatibility, better customization, and an overall cleaner experience for your workflow. You can grab it right now over at primalvfx.com, and as always, free updates are included in your purchase, so you are always getting the latest improvements. Check the product links below to get your hands on it, and let's keep pushing the limits of what is possible in 3D.
Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the content, you know what to do. Subscribe to my channel for more awesomeness, and I'll see you guys in the next video.